The World Bank, through a statement published on August 8th, announced a halt on funding to new projects in Uganda in response to the recent enactment of the Anti-Homosexuality Act 2023. The decision was highly castigated by Ugandans. Now legislators have come up to slam the International Credit Facility.
We should stand firm. We should not panic. We should not be intimidated, because Uganda is a member of World Bank.
Led by Asuman Basalirwa, the move of the bill, lawmakers registered concerns that the wrath of World Bank sanctions will not even spare the minorities which the bank purports to protect.
So again, the World Bank should be well advised that in this country, sexual orientation, gender, or any other orientation you want to call it, is not a prerequisite for access of medical facilities anywhere. It's not a prerequisite.
James Nsababutoro, the MP for Fumbira East, who doubles as the chairperson of the Parliamentary Forum on Ethics and Integrity, says World Bank's grounds are premised on disrespect of Uganda's traditional values.
Anyone who says we are going to negotiate with these people, you are wasting your time. You're not serious, because they know that it's that dominance that allows them to benefit from our resources. And you can't discuss with somebody whose primary intention is to continue exploiting from you.
MPs wondered why Uganda is being selectively targeted, and yet a number of countries in the Middle East which hang homosexuals remain with strong ties with the West and the US.
What we would wish to see is Africa uniting and strengthening their resistance and in order to demand for a just world. And we have a reason for this, really, that Africa needs herself more than she needs development partners.
The communication from the World Bank is to the effect that there will not be any new loan requests from the World Bank. But those that had already been approved, those that were already in the pipeline, will come. That money will come.
Legislators called the World Bank to order to stop meddling into social affairs of sovereign states and stick to its cardinal obligations of international financing.
So the World Bank, I want to request you, stick to your core mandate and please respect Uganda, because it's a sovereign nation with its own values. And this is all that we are promoting.
Some legislators believe their actions against Uganda were a blessing in disguise to wake up the economy to support itself without foreign financing.
And address the issue of corruption, fight corruption to the dot, we can be able to stand by our own.
Last week, President Yoweri Museveni again took on World Bank with another report in which he described its sanctions against Uganda as a provocation meant to intimidate Ugandans. Reports compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.